Hello, my creepy weasels. Today, I would like to share with you a little espresso rig I created. It's called the Vertigo Cam, also known by the push-pull effect. If you don't know what that exactly is, or you just want some more information about it, I know just the guy who can explain this much better and much faster than I do, and that's my good old friend, Ryan Connolly. Well, technically he's not really my friend since I don't know him, but I'm a subscriber to his channel Film Riot, and that's why I'm gonna leave a link in the description below. And if you like my channel, then feel free to subscribe here. But now let's get into it. The Vertigo Cam. So I created a little setup here. This is the Vertigo Cam itself, which is actually all you're gonna get once you download it. It has a Vertigo tab on it, and then you have a couple of inputs and just a couple of outputs. You can't really edit this. This will hop back every time you try to change anything. It's just information for you from where you started at and where your camera is right now. This will make sense in a little bit. So what we have here is a cube, which is our point of interest. And within this cube, there is a target, which we're gonna use since it makes a huge difference if you put the target at the front of your cube or at the back of your cube. And the other part is just a background, because without a background, you ain't gonna see no effect. Now, let's create a second view panel just so we can actually edit our camera and view the effect at the same time. So in here, let's jump into the Vertigo Cam. I also set up in the Vertigo Cam a composition grid and tried to make it as obvious as possible. I hope you can see this after the YouTube compression. But just to show off that the cube, which is always meant to be the same size, will actually stay the exact same size. So now, let's click on the Vertigo Cam. Let's get into our Vertigo tab. Let's put our target into the target. And now, let's watch the magic. All we have to do is, once our camera is set up, at first you can just move it freely so you can set up your camera. And once you hit Vertigo, everything freezes the data inside. And now whenever you start moving your camera, the object stays always the same size and the background gets pushed and pulled, which is known as the Vertigo effect. And that's pretty much it. And right down here in your references, you see you started at a 36 millimeter focal length. And once you move this around, you're actually ending at a 24.51 millimeter focal length. And also you have the distance starting and right now between the object and the camera. The other option is lock on. And all this does is to keep your point of interest or your target in the middle of your sight. That's exactly what the target tag in Cinema 4D is doing. So, and now whenever you move the camera, your camera is always focused at your point of interest. So this can lead to some nice effects, maybe not with a plain background, but once you put in a sphere here, this is actually kind of nice. So, but this goes out of the actual Vertigo effect. This is just for you to play around since we have the ability to do it. Feel free to play around with this cam as much as you want. It's free for download at my website. I'm gonna leave the link in the description. And I'm always glad to see if you have any work to show off and used it. In that matter, please like and subscribe, and I will see you next time. Stay smart.